be really excellent in education, it's really important that you mix up all the traditions of the past, as well as be incredibly forward-looking. And at the King's School Canterbury, we've always done both those things. If you look out of the window, you can see buildings, courtyards, quads, as ancient as the universities of Oxford and Cambridge. So in this historical setting, where so much has happened in English history, that the girls and boys of our school have grown up and been educated. Equally, and just as importantly, particularly with our links with our friends in China, we are forward-looking and pursuing science, the creative arts, and as well as that, the technological side of education. They must be happy, and that's the centre of everything in terms of education. Secondly, there's like a triangle between the parents and the school and then the young person. If each part of the triangle is harmoniously joined up, then the happiness of the child will then lead to success. But the third thing, which I think is really important, is that if a young person has a strong sense of their own confidence in who they are, have, thanks often to the school, a clear idea of a pathway towards their future, then they will succeed. We are so lucky at King's that we have diversity of talents. And the idea of the school is to share those talents with each other, both for the benefit of the school, but also for personal development. A school, if it's going to be successful, has to have that balance between the academic and the co-curricular, and encourage the two together. And that's what we do at King's. If only we can channel, and obviously with our partnerships both in Hong Kong and also in Shenzhen, there's a strong sense in which connecting people together, harnessing this creative energy through the power of schools, we can make a difference. We can, in a small way, change the world.